Hey guys, welcome back to the garage. Today we're back on the backup cameras. If you looked at one of our earlier videos, we added a $20 Amazon camera to the Evo 3R X3, and I'll put a link up here to it just so you can see that. That was using the PMX3 head unit. Now the camera works great for what it is, but the problem is the screen is small. And I don't have that in this machine. I don't have a PMX3 head unit. So what we're doing is we're going to add a Wi-Fi camera. Found these on Amazon, and supposedly they're going to send a very clear and good signal to the tablet, which we use for music, GPS, and now we're gonna use it for a backup camera. It's gonna mount somewhere back here. There was a plate holder here, but since we threw that away, because stupid. So we're gonna figure out somewhere to place it on here. So let's see what's in the box. I think this thing ran about $100. Open her up, see what we got. Okay, so this is the license plate itself. It's got some pretty good weight to it. So our plan is we're going to remove the camera part off of the frame and see where we can mount it. And then this will wire in here. And then it should send, and then I guess you have to download an app, which I'm sure all these instructions tell us what to do. And then this little gadget here, you can find these on Amazon, you can find these all over the internet. What this does is actually on the firewall, this actually goes into your brake light and pigtails off it. So you can use it for your whips, or you can use it for a chase light. It has three wires coming off it. One's for brake, one's constant, and one's ground. So we're gonna run the constant power to the camera. So whenever the machine is on, the camera will be on and hopefully broadcasting to the tablet so I can see what the hell's behind me. So it looks like there's a couple of Allens right at the top. We're gonna go ahead and take those out and see if we can feel this, see this camera comes apart. We don't know if this is how it comes apart, we're just thinking it does.
Definitely gonna be these two as well.
Okay, so there's four screws back here. Like I said, guys, this is the first time we've seen this too, so we're kind of trail by error, and we kind of went on the inclination that camera would come out of there.
Well, my guess is that we'll end up putting it back in this and cutting these off and using that as your mounting point, because that's all the camera is.
Okay, yeah, so we cut it here and here, you thinking?
Yeah, just cut this, round this off here.
Yes, well, it's...
I'll just take the screw and round that off.
All right.
Parts for sale too.
Huh?
So that parts for sale
everywhere. Yeah, parts for sale everywhere. What we did, smoothed it all off, made it all nice and pretty so it'll fit. And according to our calculations, it should fit right here very easily. Little nut and bolt through that nice strong plastic. Lots of room to run our wire. So the next thing we have to do is we gotta figure out the wiring. And like I said earlier, this little, what the heck I did with it? What did I do with that thing? Oh, there it is. This little jumper is going to go right here, and that'll give us power. We'll run it to the back somehow, nice and clean. And then that should just all mount up nicely in a perfect world. That should work. Never works out that easy, but we're hoping this one does. Okay, so here's what we found out. That little piggy tail thing does not go where the firewall is. It actually connects right to the back of the taillight. It said that it attached to the firewall. Well, they're a liar. But it does work. So we put it in there in the taillight. We've got it all wired in kind of half-assed right now. And if you give it some power. So once it reads the Wi-Fi, it should connect instantaneously. That's the plan. We can look at each other. So we're gonna have wired in permanently, but it looks like it's gonna work. We just gotta mess with the settings. There's actually very few settings on that app. It's SWD camera. It's on the Play Store. There wasn't a whole lot of settings there. We're still messing with it to figure it out. You got to make sure the rotation of your camera is correct, because we mounted the first time we mounted it upside down and there was no way to auto rotate it. So we're going to clean all this wiring up, and it should be, look, it's going to work okay. Pretty simple install, pretty decent looking camera. Okay guys, so we got it all finished up here. So that's where we mounted it, and then you'll see wiring coming off of the taillight. And then we ran it this way to keep it away from the heat. Everything looks, that's the Wi-Fi signal right there. We keep that nice and tidy up there. Let's see from the backside. Okay, so I'm gonna do a live demonstration here to show you how fast this, how it works. So, key in, give it some power. Right there, it sees it. So hit here, hit the button. There it is. That's our live view right from the shop. Looks great. It's not super high definition, but it's more than anything I'm ever gonna need for backing up for sure. Okay, that's it from the garage on that one. Pretty nice, easy install. If you don't want to run a wired connector and you want to use the Wi-Fi on your tablet, this is a pretty good option. $100, can't really complain. Haven't tested it yet, but if it falls apart or it's a piece of crap, I'll let you guys know. Appreciate you watching. Hit the subscribe button if you like what we're doing, and we'll talk to you soon.